Oh, here are my two pieces. I flattened them out as much as I can. And now I'm just gonna iron them flat with a little bit of steam. A little bit of steam never hurt. You see the difference between the one that I've ironed, at least on one side, do it on the other side too, and the one that I haven't. So do them both. This really, once you put it together, you can iron it after every washing. It's going to get a little wrinkled like they were before. You just iron them flat again. Okay, now the process of putting this together. You need two adjuster clips. What you're going to do, I like to make sure that the side that doesn't have the interfacing is facing out. It just, when you tie it, it means that the bow tie, you can have a little more of the wrinkly tie of the bow tie. It looks nicer. So with one of these, I'm going to come around like this. And on the back side, we need to fasten it. I don't like seeing this because it'll also unravel. So I'm going to tuck it under. This is why I gave myself a little bit of extra room on the pattern, on the length of this. I'm gonna tuck it under like this, and I'm gonna sew it shut. I'll put a row of stitching here and a row there. I'll show that to you on the sewing machine in a minute. But let me finish this so you can see how this works. On the other side, this one's gonna loop through and adjust onto this. So here's how it works. First, I'm going to take my second adjuster clip. I'm going to go up through, and if this comes out just right, I think these are 3/4 inch. I think, yeah, 3/4 inch. Inch ones tend to get kind of big, but it should just fit. So you're going to go up, and you're going to come back down. If it helps to lay it out like this, go ahead. And sometimes they don't want to cooperate. So that's step one. Make sure you have your wrong side is underneath on this one to keep it straight. I'm going to give myself a lot of excess for what we have to do next. I'm going to come as far down as I can, and I'm going to leave a little bit of a loop here. Now we're going to go under and wrap around. Remember, we came in through the top from this side. We're going to come in through the top for this side as well. And bring it in as close to this guy as you can, because now we got to go back through underneath. I'm going to go in on the first side. Stuff it in, and then once it's through, you can line it up right. Again, I'm going to give myself more room here. Hope you guys can see this. I'm going to pull it way up. Usually I sew this all together first, but I want to show you guys. So I came back up this side, and I'm going to go back down through this side. Sometimes you got to yank it out of the way, get a little bit of a corner through, and grab it. Now again, forget this side for a second. This side, if you sew it on first, don't have to worry about it. We came up and down through this guy, back and underneath this, up and down again. Now I'm gonna back it up so I have just enough to fasten here. This is good. Maybe a little less. What I'm going to do is I'm going to fasten this to itself right here, because that lets you do all the rest of the adjusting. It can slide all around. So the same thing I did on this side. Remember on this side, I'll show you this again at the sewing machine. Fold it over. I'm going to fold this back over on itself too. And just sew it on so it's attached. It's wrapped right tight around this guy. But it gives you tons of room to adjust on the other side. So, yeah, I know this keeps coming off. Because I'm trying to do one shot here. Let's go to the sewing machine and I can finish this up for you. Okay, so here we are back over at the sewing machine. And all that crazy complicatedness I did over here, I can show you again in a minute. But here's what I want to do. I want to show you on this first side. So the first side, remember I said I went in? And on the back side, I'm going to fold it over. I want just enough. I can fold it over and stitch it together really tightly. So the first row I'm going to do, keep all this as out of the way as I can. And I'm going through a whole lot of bulk here, so I'm actually going to lengthen my stitches a little bit, because they have to punch through a whole lot more. I'm going to ram it under, I'm going to try to get as close to the edge as I can, bring my foot down. I might have to help it through a little bit, and I'm going to reverse. I am going to backstitch this. And if it gets stuck, you just kind of ease it through. And on this side, again, I'm going to backstitch a little bit to really keep it as secure as possible. I have a nice little thing that clips the thread for me over there. So, and again, it's not going to be perfect, but, and something funky did happen there. I might try to clip that one off. That might be because I wasn't holding the stitches too well. But I also want to get another row. That's because it got stuck at the beginning. I had to ease it through. So you really want to be on top of that. I'm going to get another row that's not too far away from it to catch the inside of this too. And I might just go back and this is another way you can do it. Just go back and forth a couple times. And again, if that happens, it's going to leave a big wonky thing on the other side. And I'm going to trim all these ends down later. Actually, let me trim them for you now. I might have to trim them even more later. That got stuck under there. If you don't like how that looks, you can always rip it out and do it again. I'm going to trim that down a little bit. So, now the other side. The biggest trick is you've laced them together right if this part that you do under and this part you're about to do under are on the same side of the tie. If one's on the outside, it's going to show, it's going to look weird. So remember, I came in with this one. I came up and down. Around through this, the same way I went around down through this. I came back and went up and down inside of this. So now I'm ready. And because this is so bulky, you might need to give yourself a little excess in here. I'm going to pull it up and pull it down. That's why you make this side a lot longer, so you have some excess to play around with. Again, I'm going to fold this in. Get it as flat as I can, and I'm going to put one row of stitches here and one row right inside. So this, you want this loop to be as big as possible to give you maneuverability to jam this guy under your machine. And I'm going to check and see where this needle's coming down. I want it a little closer to the edge. I lift and raise my foot, move it a little closer to the edge. Okay, so here we go. Back it up a little, go forward. Try not to let it catch. Back it up a little, and come back forward. I have one side. I'm gonna reinforce it with another row of stitches a little bit further over. And again, I needed space because my foot's not going to go any closer to this, right? And another way that you can trim these down, take a seam ripper. You can snip them really close with a seam ripper. If it doesn't get close enough because you're trying to look at it through a camera lens, you can get in closer later with scissors. There we go. Now this is secured in. Now the last part would be learning how to tie a bow tie. You're gonna have, if you don't already know how to tie a bow tie, you're gonna have to look that up. There we go. We have a bow tie. That is done and adjustable. So thanks again for coming along on my journey on how to make a bow tie. I'll post a separate video of how you tie these suckers because it takes a little bit. But I've learned how to do them pretty successfully. So if you're interested in these, which I sell to raise money for cystic fibrosis research, or if you want to try your own, I hope I've inspired you to do that. I also can make them in other fabrics as well. So may your adventures in crafting bring you joy and happiness and bow ties.